All right, ladies and gentlemen, nice to have you on board for today. We're talking about the material in Unit 11, which is page 11-1 in your course pack. Now we're going to start talking about AutoCAD's basic draw and modify commands. So the idea is at the end of our instruction, you'll be able to use these basic draw and modify tools in order to draw with accuracy. And you'll be able to check your work too to make sure what you have drawn is what you intended to draw. We have a lot of commands we're learning this week. We also have a lot of different tools we're going to be using from the status bar to help us to draw with accuracy. So very exciting. What we're going to do then is we're going to get things kicked off, and we'll talk about how we can graduate on to our next level of CAD operation now that we understand some of the basics about CAD, how AutoCAD is set up, what the basic AutoCAD setup should be like, and additionally, what coordinates are and how coordinates work. So when we talk about ways to create and edit vector graphics, or ways to create and edit the geometry in AutoCAD, we've had several methods, right? We had the eyeballing it method. And what can we say about eyeballing? Well, it's a terrible idea. Never works out. AutoCAD zoom is too powerful for you to hide anything. You need to be accurate, because if you're not, it's going to come out sooner or later. Eyeballing it is unprofessional. Eyeballing it is sloppy. Eyeballing it is amateurish. It's the mark of somebody that opened the program once or twice, doesn't understand how it works, and is just goofing around. You can't be taken seriously if you draw things by eyeballing them. We learned about the other option, though, for trying to have a little accuracy. It was called snap to grid. Well, with the snap to grid, the idea is we can set the spacing on the grid in AutoCAD, and then we can make the cursor jump from grid point to grid point. And that was accurate, right? But there was some drawbacks. It was tedious. Every time you want to draw something, you have to set the grid. And let's face it, the world is not in perfect half-inch increments or quarter-inch increments. It would be a real pain in the neck to have to go in there and constantly modify the grid to whatever increment we're working with. So snapping to grid is accurate, but it's also amateurish. It's what people do who barely know how to use the program. And then forget about how much time do we have to spend looking at the screen, counting little boxes, trying to remember how much we've counted as we're trying to draw things to accurate sizes. It's just way too much work to use the snap to grid method most of the time to draw. So we talked about coordinates, and then coordinates we learned are a way to be precise, and they are accurate. Coordinates are laser precise and perfectly accurate every time. What are the drawbacks? Well, you know, there's some math, right? And not that it's hard math, but it does involve you doing some mental math. It does involve some positive and negative numbers. It can be a little confusing, maybe jumping back and forth through the coordinate systems. It's slow. You know, if you thought, man, how do people actually draw things in this software if all they have is coordinates? Well, you'd be correct to say that's a pretty slow way to draw. In fact, I think I could probably draw by hand faster than you could draw things by typing out coordinates one point to another. So here we are, though. Now we're at our final point of discussion, and it is what we're going to learn in Unit 11. We're going to learn some CAD magic that will enable us to draw with accuracy, but will also give us a high rate of speed. We're going to go really fast. And I know that's what you've all been dying for, right? We want to be like Ricky Bobby, and we want to go fast. So how are we going to do it? Well, I'm going to show you how to use the drawing tools to the best advantage. You really probably want to follow along with me. So I'm going to provide a file for you that you're going to download, in fact, several files. And then as I do these exercises on the screen, the expectation is that you are going to do the same thing. You're going to watch me do it. You're going to try to do it yourself. If it works, great. If it doesn't work, well, you know, rewind the video a little bit and watch it again and then try it again. The point is, just watching is not going to teach you how to use AutoCAD. You have to get your hands involved. You have to be clicking the mouse and touching the keyboard and using your eyes and thinking about what you just saw and creating those neural pathways so the next time you have to do it, it's in your brain. Okay, so without much further ado, let's get started. So the file I'd like you to download and to use, go over to my downloads folder, is called, let's see, where are you? Exercise 3A, Basic Draw and Modify. Let's open that up. And what we're going to see is the screen has been arranged with several different sets of drawing panels. We'll be working on them one at a time as we work our way through the draw and the modify panels in AutoCAD. Okay, so the first thing we're going to be working with is actually not a drawing tool or a modify tool, but a tool down here on the status bar. So how's your status bar looking? Do you have things turned on, but you don't know what they do? Well, if that's the case, right, we should be turning them off. Can you see all the tools on the status bar? See, if you can't, then we should be clicking on the hamburger. To make sure that there is a check mark in front of all of the tools. Right? If there's no check mark, it means I can't see it, and this could be problematic, so make sure there's a check mark. Right? And now I can see all the tools, and then my next step is going to be see which ones are turned on. If it's blue, it's turned on. If it's blue, and you don't know what it does, and you don't need it, turn it off, right? All right, and then how's our command line? Is our command line anchored at the bottom of the screen? Can you see a few lines of text? See if you can, then we're ready to go. So we did talk about the grid button, and the grid is a great thing. You know, makes me feel comfortable like I'm drawing on graph paper when I have the grid on. You don't absolutely need the grid though. For us today, you know what? You don't need it on, you can turn it off. The snap to grid button, really, there's no reason for you to probably ever use this tool again. Not gonna lie to you. It's like training wheels on a bicycle. Okay, and a week ago, 2 weeks ago, you were just learning how to ride your bike and the training wheels were necessary, right? But if you were a 30-year-old man driving down the street on a bicycle with training wheels, people would start wondering about you. And I will wonder about you if you have snapped a grid on, okay? Because we're going to learn how to draw things accurately without having to count the little squares on the screen, okay? Let's move down the status bar a little ways, though. And what we're looking for is we're looking for a tool called Object Snap, or OSnap. You can turn the Object Snap button on down here. You can also hit F3 on your keyboard and that'll turn it on. Okay, so there's a couple of ways to activate that Object Snap. And that's the subject we're going to start with here, Object Snaps. So what is an Object Snap? Well, Object Snaps are tools that are built in to help you so that when you're drawing, you can connect to things you've already created. For example, I want to draw a line, and I'd like to start that line here, and I'd like to connect it to the endpoint of that yellow line. Well, you see, the problem is I don't know what coordinate is out there, do I? If I wanted to connect to this endpoint, same thing. I don't know what the coordinate is. So how can I get it to go out there and touch? Well, when that Object Snap button's on, do you see how that just lit up? Let's look a little closer. See, there's a little golden square. And when you see the golden square, even if you're not right on top of it, AutoCAD will assume that you want to connect to that point. And if you left click, bam, you are now attached. I'm going to go back here to the beginning, and I'm going to click again, and I'm going to head down to this end, and then whack, look at that, got the other Object Snap. All right, so the idea is that lines have endpoints, and you can connect to any endpoint of any line by looking at the endpoint Object Snap while you're working. Now, how did AutoCAD know that I wanted endpoints? Well, if you give a click on a little arrow next to the Object Snap tool button, you'll see that AutoCAD actually can go and find lots of things. So the ones that are most often set up when you turn it on are probably going to be, well, I don't care what you have set up. I know that endpoint and center point are generally on by default. Let's go through and let's set a few of them up, okay? Endpoint, midpoint, center point. Those are all good. How about intersection? All right, those will be our first four. So we were able to connect to endpoints because AutoCAD is looking for endpoints while you're drawing. And every endpoint will pop up with an orange square. Now, the other option we have for connecting to geometry that you've drawn is to a midpoint. Now take a look at the glyph. Do you see how the glyph is no longer a square? The glyph is a little triangle. And if we move close to the midpoint of a line, the glyph will pop up. And if we left click when we're next to it, AutoCAD will connect you to the midpoint. Even if you're not exactly on it, AutoCAD will jump you over and attach you. Now, these are not the only way to activate your snaps. You can actually turn off the object snap, and you can talk to AutoCAD while you're drawing and say, hey, I want an endpoint. So I just started the line command, and I'm going to get close to the endpoint. You see, I don't have object snap on, so it's not giving me endpoints. But if you take a look at the command line, AutoCAD's saying, hey, specify your next point. Well, if you type in END and hit enter, AutoCAD is now going to look for endpoints. See, I was looking for endpoints even though we don't have the tool turned on. All right, so this is a second way of specifying that you want an object snap. When AutoCAD says, where do you want to go? Type in the first three letters of endpoint and it'll find endpoints. It'll do the same thing for midpoints. If you say, hey, I want to start here and I want to connect to a midpoint, but you don't have object snaps on, type MID, right? MID, first three letters of midpoint. And now as you get close to midpoints, it'll find them for you. Okay, so now what's the advantage of having the button on? Well, if the button is not on, END, AutoCAD will give me a single snap, bam. But then the next time that I want to snap, I'm going to have to type END again. And then to get to the next one, I'm going to have to type in END again. So this can be a little tedious, right? Typing out END over and over when the tool on the status bar is depressed. Then your object snaps are running in the background. So these are called running object snaps. See, it's on all the time after we start drawing our line. So there's nothing wrong with typing end or mid if you want to specify that you want an endpoint or a midpoint. But the reality is it's just easier to leave the object snaps running while you're working. This way they're there when you need them.